Welcome back to the SSL Family Dad channel. Today, we're just gonna do a quick update on the whole drainage system or drainage problems that we've had here in our pastures around the farm and some of the ditch digging and fixes that we did about a month ago. We'll just check in on that and see if it's working, how well it's working, and what adjustments we need to make. We've had some kind of rainy weather here. It's been warmed up and a lot of the snow, we had about 6 inches of snow on the ground, it's been melting, and so we've got a lot of water laying around, and so we'll see how things look. I'll take you inside really fast and show you where the water, most of the water starts that ends up in our pasture. So this little corner of the basement here is where the sump pump is, and you can see how much water flows in here constantly. Those two pipes run around the foundation of the basement from either side, and they're porous, so they're sock drains, I think. And all the water from around the house drains away from the house this way instead of into the basement. So I actually have three different pumps in here. I have a low pump, which is on that float. And you can see it runs about every 30 seconds. This tall one here, this pedestal pump, that's in there as a backup. So if that one fails, which has happened before, then this pedestal pump will pick up and take over. And if the power goes out, I have a battery backup one down there at the bottom as well. This is how wet it is around the house here. A lot of water. So right buried underground here coming from the house, from that sump pump drain, is a drain tile. And I connected it to a new piece of drain tile that I ran in here and ran down this kind of, you can see where I dug the low area. This normally has been drained out pretty well, but right now there's so much water that I still need to do some work with digging the rest of the ditch through here. And so you see we've got water backing up in this low spot. So I need to level this out better, and we need to work on getting the level of this little pond drained down. This little pond, though, has been great for the horses so far. It's given them a fresh, unlimited supply of water there. This does not freeze, and it always is flowing for them. So it's always fresh, clean water, and it's been working really well. That flows kind of through Virginia, the pigs area here. And you can see this is an area where I still need to do some work. I want this to be a nice drainage trench here, and I'll probably bury some drain tile in. I'm gonna jump in the pasture over the fence here, and we're gonna pick the drainage ditch up right over there on the other side of the fence. I'm sure Maple, the cow, is gonna follow me around out here, and the dog will run the whole property trying to get in. Well, hello there, I don't have any food. I have nothing. The water all kind of spills out in here. This is the area that I need to fix in Virginia's pasture I just pointed to. And now we're gonna pick up the drain here. And this goes out and connects to the new drainage ditch that I dug. All this was dug by hand with a shovel before I had that excavator. That goes out that way. We'll take a look at that in a minute. But you can still see, I do have quite a bit of water that settles in the pasture here. And so I may need to kind of dig a little bit of a swale or kind of a low area, maybe a little very shallow ditch, wide shallow ditch that connects over to this area to help to drain some of this. But this doesn't usually get too deep, and it drains off pretty quick. This is the part I dug by hand with a shovel, and I also scooped some of it out with the bucket of the tractor before I had that excavator again. And this all needs to be cleaned out still, so we can get the level of the horse pasture down a little bit lower. But you can see it's still flowing through here and still not flooding the pasture, so that's still doing its job. And you can see this is where I connected it through and dug a little bit of a ditch here that goes out into that pond that was here when we moved in. And then my new trench starts over there. But before that was dug, this whole area would be underwater. So all the pasture from over here, you know, we'd be under a good foot of water. This tree right here, the water was usually up about 18 inches on this tree. I mean, this was just solid, like a lake out here. This is not my maple forest, for those of you who have been following along. This is our side pasture near the house. There are a few maple trees out here. This one I used to have to wade out to, and there's a couple more in here that I used to have to wade out to, and I can get to these trees on dry ground now. But there's still work to be done out here. You gonna follow me? I didn't get any food since last time you checked. Yeah. She's she's been kind of a sweet cow, but she's still a little bit shy around me, so I'm just always I always feel like she's one step away from bowling me over. But she's been pretty nice so far. We've only had her for about 6 months now, so still getting to know each other. You gonna follow me all the way? Yeah. So the water flows down here, and you can see how much water. I mean, this is mostly coming from the house, this flow of water. And a lot of it's draining and melting snow and stuff like that also. But even when it's when everything's frozen solid, this is still running just about at this level. So you can see how much water dumps into this pasture all the time from around the house. It's a lot of water. And again, same thing here. The goats and the cow that are out in this pasture, they'll drink out of this. This is just fresh, clean water. It's coming from underground, and they always have fresh thawed water to drink. So it's been really good for them. So this is where I broke into that pond and connected this up. And this is the new drainage trench. This is what made all the difference that drained this entire pasture out here. And you can see water's flowing really good down through this. It's definitely not level or perfect, but it kind of found its own level. And it's kind of eroded its way through and turned into a nice little creek here. So I know a lot of people have made comments about, you know, don't put that on YouTube. You're digging trenches and draining water, and you're going to get, the EPA is going to come after you and all these things. So I guess just to put everyone's mind at ease, this is not considered a wetland or anything like that by any federal standard or local standard. This is farmland. This is a farm pasture. They actually offer grants in my area to help with drainage projects like this. They'll pay for drain tile, they'll pay for you to, they want you to be able to use the land for farming and to grow food and raise animals and things like that. And so this project here, I actually cleared with the county before I started. I checked with them because I'm tying this into a drain that is maintained by the county. And so I wanted to make sure that was all good. I had a guy come out, I showed him what I wanted to do. He said, go for it, don't worry, you know, you're good. And so I did it. There's no special permit required here to do this. This is considered runoff, and it's basically man-made. It's coming from our house mostly, and this is just to improve the land. They would consider this a land improvement type project, and so this is we're not harming any animal. There's no wetland wildlife that live here. This is dry for half of the year or more, and it just gets wet when we have wet periods in the spring and sometimes in the fall, and that's pretty much it. So so hopefully that helps put everyone's mind at ease about the wetlands. We're not wrecking anything. This is just, we're just hopefully helping things out, actually helping things grow and live better out here. That's the idea anyway. We'll just walk this trench out here and follow it all the way out to the county drain. Some people asked, what is a county drain? Many years ago, in fact, I think looking at old aerial photography of this land, when they cleared this land and turned it into farmland, you know, maybe 100 years ago, they came through, they had a lot of, you know, wet areas and things like that. And so back in the 50s, 60s, and 70s, they would come through and they would dig drainage ditches and put in drain tiles, pipes underground to drain low areas and swamps and other things so that the farmers could have more usable land. So they wanted to allow for us to grow as much crops as possible. And a lot of land was cleared and drained through those projects that were funded by the federal government and state and local governments. And so that's what the county drain is. It's just an old drain tile that used to be buried underground. It's just it's a constant flow. 24/7, just running water, moving towards eventually ends up in the river. So here's where it goes underneath the fence here. And what I'm gonna end up having to do here, I'm probably gonna bury a drain tile and put some kind of a standpipe in here. And I might dig a little pond here for a watering hole, but I wanna be able to cover this hole under the fence so animals can't get out. If a pig gets in here, they can run right through that. So. But then this runs out into the real deep end of the trench, and so we'll go check that out. This was, well, let's go take a look. You found me. Good job. So this is a hay field. This is the end of one of our smaller hay fields, and this is the end that comes up to this ditch here that we dug. This is the deepest end of the ditch, of course, because the water needs to run downhill. This ditch here was dug a little bit wider. This is really sandy, and so what I may do, my plan has changed a little bit. I may bury a drain tile for this section from the end there all the way back to where we go under the fence here where I just showed you. And she's here again. Maybe I'll put a drain right here in the middle to drain this area. But this just isn't really working out the way I had hoped. I mean, even though I dug it wider with all the sand and everything, I mean, by the time this erodes out, you know, it's gonna be 15, 20 feet wide, you know, slope and everything, and I'll have to come out here and do quite a bit more work. So I'm thinking that just burying a drain tile for this section won't cost too much. You can see, you know, a lot of it has caved in and a lot of it was dug too deep. I don't have a laser level or anything, so it was dug too deep here and then not quite deep enough at the end. So we got a lot of standing water in the trench, but it's working. Remy, don't go in the water. You can see this is just way too deep in here. All the standing water doesn't need to be in here. So this could be probably about a foot shallower here, and then maybe about 6 inches deeper at the end, and this will drain right out. So we'll work on that. Here we're coming to the end, and this is, you can see this needs to be dug a little bit deeper through here, but water's flowing good. And this is what I called the county drain. This was dug, as far as I can tell, back in the 60s, and there is a drain tile pipe underneath here somewhere. I think that broke many years ago, and then they just came back and dug this big ditch out. I mean, you can see these trees all in here. The last time it was cleaned out, I mean, you know, these trees are probably 25 years old, so you know, it's been at least that long, but I would say quite a bit longer than that since this has been cleared out. Remy, get out of the water. Get out of the water. But you can see it's draining. This is all coming from the house and in the pasture. Remy. A lot of water clearing out of that area up there that's gonna help help the animals have a better life there and help the trees grow better. We're not draining all the water off. I don't want it to be a desert. It's just helping with some of the runoff from melt and rain. That's all it is. So this will be another project that I will have to work with the county on specifically. They maintain this section of the drain, and this goes all the way back to my maple forest. So you can see way back there, there's a big forest, and this is where this needs to be cleaned out to drain that maple forest, and that's going to be another project. But you can see a lot of water here standing, and this all needs to be cleared out. This goes up to the road, and then it cuts into a couple other ditches that are maintained by the county and a couple other drain pipes that eventually drain all the way back into a pretty good-sized river nearby. And so it just takes all this water out of here. So a little side note, this is a willow tree, and I was up at the park where I collect wood sometimes. They dump wood cuttings up there in the back, and there was a bunch of willow cuttings up there, a bunch of willow branches and willow logs, and I stuck a few of these branches that I found up there. They had sat there over the whole winter. I picked them up last spring and I stuck them in the ground. Just dug a hole about 2 feet deep, stuck the branch in there, and they all rooted, and there was quite a few leaves on this last year. So we'll see if we can get a willow tree growing. I think we'll see if it buds again this year, if it's still alive. Willow trees are great, especially for this wet area. She found a dead animal to roll in somewhere. That's awesome. Ugh. So this is what I have to look forward to still. And this is the real job. This is the maple forest. This is the sugar bush where all the maple trees are. Over 100 maple trees out here. And it's a mess. And this is that drainage area. You can see it kind of gets lower right here. This is that county drain that came through here, and it goes up between the two farmers field. That's my neighbor's property, and then this is that hay field. You can see the drainage ditch way down there that we were just at. and this water is supposed to be flowing out of here down that way, and it's just so eroded in and grown over in the middle of this section right here that this will not drain anymore. So you got all this standing water. I mean, this is 2, maybe 3 feet deep in here in some of these areas. And that dog is gonna fall through the ice. Once I get that, work with the county, get that drain cleared out, then the maple forest will drain down. It won't be perfect, but at least it won't be, you know, 2-3 feet deep water. That's just it's just ridiculous for doing maple syrup out here. So just a little update today on the drainage out here. It's been a, you know, this has been one of the biggest kind of struggles that we've had moving out into this property. It's just a really flat area that we moved into out here, and it took a couple years for us to figure out. You know, we had a couple wet springs and we're like, oh, this is going to collect water. There's a lot of water here, there's a lot of water there. So we need to learn, you know, where those issues are on the land here and how to correct that so that we can use as much of this property as possible and for what we want to use it for, which is farming and raising animals and growing things. And so we can't do that underwater. So we gotta do something about that. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the quick update on the drainage ditch digging out here. And that seems to be one of my part-time jobs is ditch digging. So a lot of fun. Don't forget to hit thumbs up on the video today, guys. And of course, subscribe if this is your first time here. Love to have you tag along for all the fun. And as always, guys, thanks for watching. Have a good one.